Oh.
Can I just
fabulous.
Good. It's better than the hair, I think. I can't see.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna try to look big and strong.
Right. Big and
strong. Wait, just a second. We gotta lock the dogs up.
Doug, you're good. We're live, guys.
We're live now.
Hi everybody. I'm John Ranenberg.
Hey, I just want to welcome everybody to the second Arabian Horse Times Live Jeopardy. I'm Doug Stewart, and before I introduce our three contestants, I want to remind you guys to just stay online.
Michael, I need more volume.
For Joel Kiesner's Shave Off and Stallion Auction. Now for our contestants. Bringing the Pain, Mary Trowbridge of Trowbridge Limited in Bridgewater, Connecticut. She is the driving horse, the driving force behind the Arabian Horseman's Distress Fund. Bringing the Thunder, John Randenberg of Rohara Arabians in Orange Lake, Florida. John is an icon in the Arabian breed and a versatile trainer and judge. Returning Jeopardy reigning champion, Show Me the Money, Steve Heathcott of Heathcott Arabians in Ocala, Florida.
Sure.
Been a success in the show ring all over the country, and we are very excited to have him join us tonight.
Can you say success all over the world?
Pretty much all over the world, yeah. Pretty much a big deal, plus success on Jeopardy, which is totally awesome. Yeah, so to answer the question, you must hit your buzz button on your phone, be the first person to light up yellow on the board, and you'll have a chance to answer the question once. Should you get the answer incorrect, the amount of points for that question will be deducted from your total. Getting the answer correct adds this amount to your total. There is one random daily double Jeopardy question, which will award two times the amount of points for that question. There will be a final Jeopardy question, which will require you to write down your bet before the question is asked your answer. So as you all may know, this Jeopardy game is a Calcutta benefiting the Arabian Horseman's Distress Fund during this uneasy time. For whichever contestant wins the game, the winning bidder for that contestant will receive 50% of the net proceeds, the other 50% going to the Arabian Horseman's Distress Fund.
And for Mike and Jeff Lee,
yes. Yes, if we have no other questions, we'll go ahead and begin. And we're gonna start tonight with our reigning champion.
Wait, so, I have a comment before we start. Can I have a comment?
We need comments.
I want to say how thrilled I am to be on this panel with Mary Trowbridge, which has been an inspiration and a seriously kind, great horse trainer, great person forever. And the same for John Ranenberg. I remember when I was 5 or 6 years old, my parents used to take me to the Nationals and I used to watch John's show. So he's been an idol of mine since I was 4 or 5 years old.
No. You have me mistaken. I'm sorry, that's not true.
Oh, he was saying a Bob Battaglia. That's right, John.
Yeah, there you go.
We're even.
All right, Steve.
Touche, Steve.
Are we ready to get going?
You guys ready?
Let's do this.
Well, I have a comment. I had to unveil because I didn't want you all to think that, you know, I shaved my head. I'm glad I didn't have to. So it's just pink, but Carolyn rocked it more than me.
Nice.
All right, are we good? Let's go.
Let's do this. Okay, Steve, you pick the category.
I'm going to go national champions for 300 to start this bad boy.
All right. These two horses are the only two full siblings to be named national champion stallion. Mary?
Oh, no. God, I knew it too. I was thinking Elkin and Elkanah, but that's wrong.
Yes, it is wrong.
Bo They were owned by the same owner.
Anybody else? I'll read the question again. These two horses are the only full siblings to be named national champion stallion.
Steve, you don't know that.
Well, I'm afraid they're going to go to the like split national champions when they're 4 years old or 6 years old. Yeah, the original national champions would shock me if there's one. But now we have too many divisions. So I don't have an answer.
John, do you have an answer?
I don't.
So okay. I win. At least I had an answer.
So that was more current.
All right. Well, I guess we'll go to Mary.
So I get to pick?
You get to pick a category? Yes, and an amount.
In for a penny, in for a ton and a half. I will go with name that photo for 500.
All right. Loving it.
Oh, God.
Take a big swing. Okay. Name that photo.
Elkin or Elkana?
I'm not buzzing it for 500. I think I know the answer, but I'm...
Okay. Steve, you're up.
No.
I'm going to lose 500 right now.
Well, I just did.
All right. So how about John?
If I guess, do I lose if I don't get it right?
Go in the whole 500.
I'm afraid to say.
Hey, can we I didn't know guess? That part of the rules.
Can we all guess with immunity after we all say we're not guessing?
Yes.
Okay.
I want to go with, and now this is for no points, correct?
Right.
Well, then I don't get any.
I'm going to go with Cedar Ridge's mare.
No. No.
All right, John, you had to guess.
1875.
I'm going to say Penicillina.
Oh, no. Too short the neck.
You got a guess?
Well, Stuart, what about you?
I've got the answer.
You probably read the question.
Yeah. Okay. So it
doesn't mean you'll get it right.
Bushman.
Really?
Bushman. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
1971 Scottsdale Reserve.
That was not a great picture. That was pretty generic. That's a gray flea-bitten Arabian. Okay. So now, John, you're up.
I'm going to say name that photo for 100, Doug.
Okay. Who is this one?
Did I get it?
John, you're up.
Do
I get a buzz in at some point, or how do I get a chance?
I buzzed. I buzzed before you wanted a chance.
How do I get an answer?
You got a buzz.
I did already. I'm next.
Can I say my answer?
John, do you have a guess?
No, I'm not going to guess.
Okay.
I'm going to say, can I answer?
Oh, Mary came up second.
Ha. Huh. So I think it's Kara George.
Nope.
Damn.
Okay, Steve.
I'm going to say El Nevado.
Yes.
Correct. Right.
There you go.
Yeah.
Correct.
That's
tough.
So do I get to go?
Yes, so Steve's back up.
What, Pat?
I'm going to say name that photo for 300.
Okay.
I got it. Did I buzz in first? I hope to God I keep hitting buzz.
John came up.
I got it?
Yes.
That, I know this answer. That, should we start with the rider or the horse?
We just need the horse.
Okay, the horse is Ambra.
Yep.
Yes, correct.
And it's a very, yes. And that's a very young Jim Stokowski.
Yep, right on. Nice. So now it's your turn again.
Name that photo for 200, please, Doug.
Okay. I buzzed in a long time ago.
Steve's buzzer is not coming up.
Who got it?
It came up as you, John.
That would be who is Telegato.
Yes. I told out of the Gata 3.
Correct.
My buzzer didn't work. I'm going to go on this all rant.
Right. Yes, it does, Steve. You just have to be a little quicker.
Well, you know, I'm getting about to pull out here in a second.
You need to shout your name next time.
Yeah. Jump up.
All right. John, you're up.
Name that photo for 400, please.
All right.
Oh.
Good Lord.
Oh.
Wow. I did not know that
one. Surprise you.
That's Coltrane? That Kiesner.
Nope. I got to tell you, that's Gene LaCroix riding.
Yeah, it is. I think so, too.
But I don't know the picture.
Golly. Aladdin?
That's pretty cool.
So, anybody got a guess?
No,
never seen that picture.
Well, whoever buzzed in lost money.
Nobody buzzed in.
No one buzzed in.
Can we answer the question, though? Who is Anadra? I don't know that.
Good answer, Mary.
was that a young Gene LaCroix riding, though?
Yes. Rider, right. And they won Scottsdale championship in the early 70s jumping.
Obviously. Cool. Yeah. He looked like he was going to grab with those hind legs, though. Didn't look like
all right. So let's just go. Let's move on to Steve.
Quarantine homeschooling for 200.
All right. For 200. This country is both an island and a continent.
Oh, my phone went buzz. I'm buzzing.
Mary?
Australia.
Yes, correct for 200.
Ha.
What is Australia?
Coming out of the hole.
Well, careful.
Okay, so pick a category.
I will take homeschooling for 300.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Since the late 1930s, this calendar date has been designated for the inauguration of the United States president.
No, I think I shouldn't guess.
No guesses. Steve?
I'm out.
John?
I'm going to pass.
Okay.
It's in the winter.
January 20th.
Somebody could have texted me that.
Yeah, really. out there.
Okay, so let's get back. Okay, Mary, it's your turn.
Didn't I just go?
Oh, you did just go. Let's go back to John.
Let's do national champions for 100, please.
All right. The most winning purebred performance horse, John.
Hi. Indy Alpericles.
Damn it.
Nah.
No?
No.
Really?
You.
Yes. Anybody else?
I have guesses, but I don't want to lose money.
Oh, I thought Perry was a...
You're going to win tonight.
Conservative.
Perry was for a long time. Somebody must have passed him.
Wasn't mine. John, was it
mine? I knew I should have called Wendy today. I was going to do that.
All right. Well,
if you know, she knows. Hey, maybe you could text me.
Hey, John. Hey, Mary. The questions are much tougher this week. I will tell
you. Very tough.
Mary, you do have to guess since you buzzed in.
Oh, damn it. I was guessing Perry too. Let's see. God.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, no.
Time's up.
Yeah. No. Thanks, John. You guess.
Cool.
Oh my God. Thanks, Larry. You could have texted me.
You need to get your
people on time.
My turn?
Okay, Steve.
What?
I'm going to go history for 200.
History for 200. The first double-double national champion, winning both U.S. and Canadian and U.S. and Canadian national champion Western Pleasure.
Did I buzz in?
Sure did.
Yes, you're in, Steve.
I want to say Kemosabe.
And you're correct.
Yes. Yay for me, finally. How come my money total didn't go up?
Whoops.
Oh. What was that?
There we go. All right, Steve.
Wait, okay. Is it my turn again?
Yep.
I'll go history 300.
Whoa.
No, it's double jeopardy.
Mary Trowbridge.
Who is Jay Scream?
Yes, correct.
Good answer, Mary.
See? Yeah.
I was going to go Norm Dunn, so I would have lost that.
Okay, Mary, you're up.
Oh, boy. I'm going to go with quarantine homeschooling for 400 because I think I should be in quarantine again. Water begins to boil at this temperature. That's science. I don't do that.
I know it.
Yeah, no. What, Pat? 212.
That is not going to count.
What do we do with that, Megan?
I don't think we can count that. I mean, you are losing pretty badly, but.
Well, they won't take it back. They can hear right. You.
On to John.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Just texted him to stop yelling at me. It's not working.
Okay, John, category?
National champions for 200.
Okay. A 17-time national champion, this stallion went undefeated from 2000 to 2004 in native costume. John.
Who is Good Thunder?
Yes.
If I didn't get that right,
there was going to be hell to pay.
That is not fair.
Keep train and ride the horse. So
I know that's why it's not fair.
Well, you might get yours too. You know?
There better be one in there for Steve and I. Right?
Okay, John, your turn again.
National champions for 400, please, Doug.
All right. In 1967, this stallion won U.S. national champion in both formal driving and formal combination, defeating the Great Bosk.
I hope I didn't buzz in. Did I buzz in? I'm going to say Royal Bennis.
Huh, you got it.
Correct.
Correct.
Jesus Christ, that scared me as soon as I buzzed in.
I'm impressed. Steve, that was good.
That was a good one.
Danny Hansen, Leo Hansen family, I think.
That proves that you were not young when you were watching Randenberg at the horse shows. Right? Just saying.
Yeah.
I'll go history for 100.
For 100. In 1985, this performance division was added to the U.S. Nationals for the first time.
John?
Did I get it?
Yep.
Okay. Country English Pleasure.
No.
Me, you're next.
Steve.
I didn't buzz it, did I?
You sure did.
Me.
Did John say 100? Junior divisions.
No.
Hunter.
Me. Harry.
Hunter.
Yes, correct.
Could have been right, Steve.
I thought John said hunters, and I was going to say hunter, and then I backed off it.
You have to pay attention, Steve.
No, that's all right. That's hard for me.
All right, Mary, it's you.
Hey, Mary.
Oh, God. Maybe quarantine homeschooling for 100 will be something I know.
Oh, this is good.
Oh my God. Okay. Oh,
she knows this. Okay, Mary.
Clouds.
Very good.
Hey. I'm impressed.
Nice. Congratulations. What are clouds? She has been homeschooling.
Yeah, just, you know, not with the pictures. Look at John, still puzzled.
All right. Now, back in your court, Mary.
Uh-oh. Well, I'm staying with my friend quarantine for 500.
Right. Oh, in God. Geometry, this six-sided shape is referenced by this name.
Shit.
John, you got this one.
Not yet.
He's thinking. Not a round pin. But close.
Mm-mm. Now that I've learned the... Oh!
Oh, Mary.
Hexagon.
Did someone just text that?
You got it.
What?
Somebody just text you that?
No!
I'm afraid we got some stuff going on here.
It kind of looked a little iffy there.
I'm afraid.
I drew a picture of it. I couldn't remember it.
Okay, Maris, back to you.
Pedigrees for 100.
Pedigrees for 100. These two stallions are the grandsires of a fire's heir.
Who buzzed in?
Steve.
Okay, yeah, you did.
Good. Let's go with Bale Bay and let's go with Bosque.
Nope.
Oh, a fire's heir. I was thinking of Fire Baby. I read that so wrong. Oh, my butt hurts.
Oh, yeah. A little concerning.
Oh, damn it.
Mary?
Well, I know one. Bale Bay and Brassmas. Brass.
That would be a girl.
Well, brass. Right?
Well, you didn't buzz in, so I can't deduct points, but that is also incorrect.
Okay. Yeah. Well, good. So I don't lose then, right?
John?
Bass.
Okay.
Who is it?
A fire baby.
Well, you were close.
Well, wait. Wasn't the question, who's his grandsire?
Yeah, these two stallions are the grandsires. So on the mare side and the stallion side.
Right.
But isn't a fire's heir is by a fire baby.
Right, and out of brass.
Oh, you know what, Ashley?
Fires. Oh, she did.
Oh, well.
No.
Fire bays.
A fire bay is his sire. So a fire bay is by... Bay, okay. And Brass Mist is by Brass. That's how I read the question. Oh, well.
Well, that's how.
Well, I read it a Fire Bay V, so how well did I do?
So you
were still wrong.
Steve, no.
So what's the answer?
Brass.
Yeah.
Fire Bay V and Brass.
But so is it Sire? Never mind. Doesn't matter. I'm confused.
Who's up?
Steve.
All right, we're getting clear.
I'll take pedigrees for 200.
Pedigrees for 200?
Yes.
Okay. 1996 National Champion Open English Pleasure Horse. WN Astra is sired by this national winning halter stallion, Steve Heathcott.
Oh, I just screwed up.
Oh.
Gay Argosy.
No.
Nah.
When you say national winning halter stallion, does that mean U.S. national champion halter stallion?
I would think so.
No, it could be top 10. I think that's the tough part of it.
Which one is?
I buzzed in. Did you get it?
Okay, John.
I'm going to say, this is a long shot. Who is Blue Spruce Tanzier?
Yes. Nice. Nice. Very good. Okay, John.
I did research that question.
We just researched the question before and actually.
It's Huckleberry Bay.
Yeah, it was wrong.
Still didn't get it right though.
Yeah,
it should be taken away from anybody. So.
Hey, can I ask my fellow competitors to quit looking down at their phone?
We're gonna need to see.
I'm looking for the buzzer. Well,
okay, John, you're up.
How do you do the buzzer then?
And I have to say, no one sent me that answer. It took me a minute. I knew it was a Wayne Newton horse. But anyway, let's say national champion.
How do you use your buzzer if you don't look down at your phone?
National champions.
For 500, please.
Oh, geez. That's a big one.
This horse was named reserve national champion stallion 3 years in a row. Steve Heathcott.
Bale Bay.
Nope.
Oh, I'm in the negative.
Oh shit, I can see him. Oh.
Mary.
Was it Top Contender?
Nope.
No.
Sorry, Katie.
I'm in the hole.
So am I. Shut up, Doug. You've got to play next time.
No, I can't. I get the answers.
No, you're not going to get them next time. You've got
to
play.
I'm not going to have to play?
Yeah.
John's got an idea. He's thinking it through. No?
Well, now I got a guess, but I'm out.
John, do you have a guess or?
I'm going to pass. I don't know the answer.
All right, I got a guess.
Okay, guess.
I was going to say Bushman, the one you showed us the picture of.
Right?
You were in the right year.
All right,
okay, now we're back to Steve.
I'm going to have to go history for 500, either go way in the hole or catch up.
We got to get out of the hole. In 1963, U.S. Nationals added performance classes for the first time. Stallion Cernit won national champion in these two performance divisions that year in 1963.
I think I got to go.
I buzzed.
Mary, you're in.
Mary.
English and Western.
That's my answer.
Yes.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
Very good.
Okay,
those were the good old days.
Yeah.
Minus 200.
Where's their score? Oh, John.
Yeah. All right, Mary. Categories?
All right. I'll go with, how far am I behind? I'm going to go for Potpourri for 200.
Oh, nice. Okay.
I don't know what that is, but.
At the 1985 Star World Show, this trainer took home $25,000 for a winning the Egg and Spoon class, Steve Heathcott.
Jim Lowe.
Barry.
Kit Hall.
Yes. Got it.
I buzzed in.
It just didn't light
just
up.
Late.
Who was Kit Hall?
I got big ones to get back in it. Whose turn?
Mary.
I'll stick with that potpourri for 100.
Alaska and Hawaii are members of these two separate regions.
Frig. I know one, I don't know the other. What was it? How much was it for?
100.
100.
All right, I'll take a stab. Seven, okay. Region 17 and region 1.
Nope.
Damn it.
Anybody else?
I ain't got no money.
So what's more, you know?
John?
I'm gonna pass. I don't know.
Guess.
No.
No.
What are regions 5 and 1?
Huh.
Oh, I was, yeah.
That makes sense.
So did 17. 17's right. Closer.
Right? So John, you're up.
Do history for 400.
This mare was the first U.S. National English Pleasure Futurity horse in 1998. Mary.
Who is Firefly in it?
Yes, she was.
Who wrote it?
There, I feel better now.
Who wrote that one?
You, Mary.
John Rannenberg. It
was her horse.
Okay, Mary, you're up.
If I can win 1,000, I got a chance. I got to kind of win out just to have a chance.
Potpourri for 300. I like that for some reason.
In 1989, these two trainers were named U.S. National Champion and Reserve National Champion in the Half Arabian Western Pleasure. You guys all know them.
I'm not going to guess.
John's thinking about it.
I have a guess, but I don't know for sure, so I'm going to pass.
Yeah.
Okay. Steve?
No, but I got a
guess?
Wild idea.
Okay. All right, Megan, what do we do?
Yeah.
Stanley
White Jr. and Stanley White. That's pretty awesome. Okay, so now I believe are we with Steve now?
Well, let's try to make a comeback. I'm going to say pedigrees for 300.
All right. Triple Crown champion, Malikian, LOA, is a paternal sibling to this U.S. Reserve National Champion English Junior Horse. Steve.
Mr. Chips?
Yes, good job.
Woo! I'm going to go pedigrees for 400. I'm still in the hole, by the way.
No, you're, oh yeah, just a little bit.
Siblings, Bosquina, Dancing Flame, La Bosque, and Queen Bosque.
I think I buzzed in.
All,
you did.
Yep, you're in, Steve.
I say Habina.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes. Who is Habina?
I'm going to say pedigrees for 500.
JK Jedi is sired by this son of Bosque.
I know everything about this and I can't think. I could tell you everything about that horse, but I can't think.
John? Nope. Mary?
I just saw a picture of that horse just recently and I can't think of it.
I'm not going to guess it.
No. All right.
So depressing.
Nobody?
Nada.
Him Shade.
Fuck you. Okay, Mary.
All right.
You got a category.
I guess it's potpourri for 400.
Potpourri for 400. This well-known breeder was the daughter of a congresswoman and a senator and for a time publisher of a newspaper. Mary.
Who is Basie Tankersley.
Nice.
Mary just won this whole damn thing.
There you go.
Okay, let's go 500. This prominent trainer and horseman was inducted to the Eastern Kentucky University Athletic Hall of Fame in 2016 as a football player.
I have no clue.
You should know this.
Well, I would if I had the answers here.
I have a guess, but I don't know.
Steve?
I got nothing to lose. Chuck Seaman.
Yes. Very good. Yes, you were right.
Holy Jesus.
Awesome.
I am back in the game.
Yes, you are.
Wait. Did you get that?
He did.
He got it right. It was Chuck Seaman.
Now you guys need to place your bets for Final Jeopardy.
By the way, Chuck is about the finest guy you can.
Yes, he is. And I'm sorry. I didn't know that, Chuck.
All right. Well, we have.
So what are we doing? What do we do? We enter our wages.
Final Jeopardy. You'll write down or enter your bet up to the total amount of your total amount of points. I will then read the question and you must write down your answer. You will have 20 seconds to write down your answer before they will be revealed. If there are no questions,
I got it.
Jeopardy.
Are we doing our bid first?
Yes, do the bid first.
So we don't need our phones anymore. We're just gonna show you our paper.
No, you do need your phones.
To bid, after you bid, or
before? After you bid, you'll enter your answers into your phone.
Oh, we're not doing
the paper. Okay.
Are we doing it? Okay. Okay, so John, you're at 600.
I put my bid in, did you get it?
You've got, nope, you just have to hit submit.
Where's submit?
How I pulled Chuck Seaman out of my ass, I had no idea.
All right, here we go.
Name four of the five stallions to ever win national championships in both open halter and performance.
I'm so glad I went all in. This is so easy.
Oh, I hate me. There were five of them?
Yep.
But you only have to name.
You only have to name four.
Oh, well, there you go. Oh, well.
We don't have to spell it correctly, do we? As long as it's close.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
If we can understand it, we'll give you the points.
Boop, 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 boop.
Oh, I got four, right? Yeah. Four. Well, should I put all five down and just show off?
Oh my God.
Do it.
I'm gonna put all five down.
Might as well. How's it going, Megan?
Steve is the only one to submit so far.
Whoa.
Because it's such an easy question.
Are we writing our question down on paper or typing it in?
I'm gonna crawl through this phone and bite you. Or through this computer.
I wish I could double check what I put because I already sent it.
You sound confident. I think you're good.
Mm-hmm. Now,
what are we doing, Mary?
I only had two.
Six.
I'm waiting for Mr. Know-It-All up there away against the wall.
He's in the office.
By the way, I think you're quite correct. Your question was incorrect. I'm pretty sure there's six.
Oh my God, he's gone. Oh,
well, yeah.
John, are you still thinking, or is someone holding you flashcards?
Did you say they had 20? I believe that's how the question was worded. You have 20 seconds to submit your answers.
Yeah, we ran out of time a long time ago.
All right, so we're going to do
Wait a minute. I lost my train. 20
seconds is over.
You lost your what?
Hold on.
My virginity. Recently. A little traumatized about it, okay?
I wasn't talking to you, Steve. I was talking to John.
Did you get my answer?
Time's up.
Got it. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, here's Steve's answer.
Who the hell's
Seamus?
Whoosh. Yeah.
Seamus.
He's still on Chuck.
He didn't. Let's see.
Yeah.
Who is that? What are you talking about, Seamus? That's an Appaloosa, Heathcott.
Yeah. Well, I still got five.
No, that's...
You got four.
I got four.
Okay, John.
Oh, it was Aramus. That was supposed to spell Aramus. A-R-A-M-U-S. Well,
Seamus does not make it.
I still got.
He was back with Chuck Seaman, still getting the Kentucky Hall of Fame.
Boskin DeBoer.
Yeah, I was way out. Do we have to show the losing test answers?
Okay, John.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Steve won that one.
Well, what is it? Oh, yeah.
Because Steve got four of the five.
Well, I got five, but I didn't put chemo, so I think technically there is six.
So Steve did get it right. Technically,
Seamus isn't a real horse.
Steve actually got four of the five.
Yeah, Johnny only got three.
God, I didn't know that.
Gay Parada, Chemo Sabian.
Winner is not.
Steve again.
Steve's buying dinner.
Nice, yes. Steve's buying dinner, and let's all stay tuned and let's watch for. The horseman's distressed. Let's watch the Joel Kiesner's shave off.
We don't have to stay.
I do want to say, John, Mary, you guys were great. If it wasn't for the damn Chuck Seaman answer, I would have been.
That's what he said last time.
Hey, I got ahead with Cumulus Clouds, so I can't complain either. Awesome.
And actually,
right, love you guys. Love you too. I'll be back.
We know, Steve. Yes, we know.
I'll come back and watch it.
Don't gloat. It's not a polite.
So good, you guys. Thank you so much for doing it.
Love you, sort of.
Thank you.
You gotta play next time, though. I'll MC and you play.
Thank you so much.
I'll MC and you play.
Okay.
John will ringmaster.
Right?
John R. will ringmaster. Jesus!
Hey, is it that bad? Come on.
Wow, looks pretty. Looks like
it's a nice round head.
It looks like you greased it up to get that hat on.
Right? I guess. Hey, I guess we're supposed to get off, and now everybody's going to watch Joel Kiesner shave his head.
Yeah, we've got Rory with us now.
Rory!
Good evening, everyone. Hey. Doug Stewart, going to Hollywood. Aaron, we're right up your alleyway here. The next half hour or so with this Kiesner Stallion shave off, we're benefiting.
I love the hair there, buddy.
Ooh, you're preemptive.
Ooh, he does, doesn't he?
We'll pay you to put hair back on.
I wore a hat, at least.
So for the ladies, Mary Trowbridge and Carol Schiller took a nice lead with painting their hair pink in support of cancer awareness. With a couple good friends are in a tough spot right now, Mary.
Well,
and we're going to be funny tonight.
And what I would say is, you know, if you, since you have such luscious locks, I mean, you don't have to take it off. Just a couple of weeks, maybe a month is in pink would be fine.
I've been growing this for 8 years. I haven't had a cut.
Yeah. Put a lot of
money into
that.
So maybe next time maybe next week we'll do halter guys with their stallions. Some big locked.
I just think pink would be fine. Yeah. Maybe better.
So we're going to raise some money for the Arabian Horse Sisters Trust Fund this evening. Selling stallion breeding, 6 beautiful English pleasure stallions, very well known pedigree, very well known show ring, very well known sires. They stand at Kiesner, and then Joel Kiesner is going to shave after each stallion breeding is sold this evening, 1/6 of his head. We're going to take some time. His daughter's going to have fun. His wife's going to have fun watching him get plucked like a chicken this evening for charity. Good evening, Joel and Ashton.
Before we get started, we're going to show a quick little video before getting underway.
Are we on?
Yeah, we're on. All right, guys, we're going to start out first with a short little video.
Hey, guys, Doug Stewart here. I just wanted to share.
Oh, my God.
Right now, there's been a few
trainers in the
West and across the country that have been shaving their heads.
And now, if you're looking at
some of
our
fellow horsemen that are going through a tough time. That's not where this ends. You know, these are certain times. You got the coronavirus. And
you know what, though?
The economy, we're all stuck at home. And there's a lot of uncertainty. But I'll tell you something. There's one thing I'm certain about. We live in the greatest country in the world, and we have the ability to reach in our pockets and help each other out during a tough time. I'll tell you what, the Arabian community sticks together like none other. And I think we can all support each other in this endeavor, trying to raise money. And it doesn't matter if it's $5 or $500 or $5,000, every little bit helps. These are trying times, and we need to help each other out. For Jeff Lee and Mike McDaniel, here we go. Now, Mike, this is for you, Mike McDaniel.
Still got a lot of fire left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried for me. I'm too deep. I'm too deep.
As I said, we don't want or think anybody should go through what you guys are going through alone. So we just
do
want you to know.
You need to do a twirl.
That we're standing with you. Through this tough time in your life. Anyway, we wish you all the best and just know you got your buddies with you. Good luck.
This is my friend. For fun, in this stupid war, we play hard
like
with
how a sense can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my
Thank you.
No, I still got a lot of fight left in me. The ransom is $1 million.
With Team Kiesner this evening for a very special night of raising money for the Raven Horseman's Distress Fund. We have 6 stallions we're going to offer that stand at Kiesner Stud, beautiful English pleasure stallions. We're going to sell them one by one, and Joel's then going to shave his head one strip by one strip with a total of 6 passes with those beautiful show clippers this evening. If you're not going to bid on a stallion, which we hope you will, you can just make straight donations this evening from $1 to $1 million. We don't mind. Raven Horseman's Distress Fund is a 501(c) tax-deductible donation and nonprofit. They're there to help the horsemen of the Raven Horse community. And so we're delighted this evening to have Joel and Ashton Kiesner host us from their farm in Louisville, Tennessee, just outside of Knoxville. Ashton and Joel, are you there with us this evening?
Yes, we are.
Thank you for taking the time and grabbing your clients together for a great cause. We're reminded how wonderful our community is, the Raven Horse business. No other breed has a Horseman's Distress Fund like what Mary Trowbridge and her team at the Horseman's Distress Fund have assembled over the last 13 years, raising nearly $2 million. And tonight it's your turn to step up with your clients and your hair, buddy.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's going to be for sure a big loss. But first of all, we want to thank everybody for tuning in. And we're really excited about tonight. We've been working really hard, and we hope for a big night. First of all, we want to thank all the stallion owners. We are super proud of them. They didn't flinch. They were excited to be able to help as well. It's an honor to be able to do something for somebody else. So we're really excited about that. So part of why we're here, I know everybody, been shaving our head. People have been shaving their heads for Mike McDaniel and Jeff Lee and Richard Petty and Chance here. Chance works with us every day, and Chance has been working with a lot of these horses for a lot of years. One of the first guys ever to ride Inception, the first really cool video of Inception that came out, Chance was on him, and it was amazing. And so when all this started to happen, I went through something this winter. My dad had a pretty scary health scare. So I can really relate to what he's going through right now. And you see everything that's going on in the world, and people are doing things, whatever they can do. I've been walking around the barn wondering, I wonder what I can do. And it just dawned on me one day, this is something I can do. We this is what we have. We have these horses, and this is our community. This is what we can do. And I got to tell you, the pieces started falling together. Laura Ames, the Raven Horse Times, the stallion owners, all the people, just things started happening so fast. So it's really, it's been amazing. But I'm going to let Chance talk here for just a second, and then we're going to get started. Chance?
Appreciate it. I just wanted to say, first and foremost, my dad, Mike McDaniel, I love you so much. I'm sorry I'm not there to be with you to go through all this together, but I'm there in spirit. I just want to thank everybody who's reached out to us, everybody who's sent us messages, everybody who's donated to the Distress Fund, everybody who's, shaved their heads, all of it. I really appreciate it so much, me, my family, everybody. And I want to thank the stallion owners for donating these stallions are awesome. Like Joel said, I worked with a lot of them since they were 3 years old. Such great horses and even better owners. Can't thank everybody enough, really, on behalf of all of us. So I guess it's
go time.
It's time to put my hair where my mouth is, I guess.
Chance McDaniel's part of the pregame party here. It's going to get us started as Joel, at least Joel, can see the other side of the razors for a moment. So as we shave Chance here, McDaniel's dad, Mike McDaniel and Gretchen McDaniel, based in Chico, California, good friends of mine for many years. I call his dad Mike McIce Cream because that guy has always got an ice cream cone after 4 o'clock at a horse show in the afternoon. Tonight's Kiesner Stallion Shave Off is powered by the Arabian Horse Times, the premier global media branding and technology company for the Arabian horse community. We appreciate Laura Ames, publisher, and her team of ladies at the Arabian Horse Times for connecting us in these uncertain times through Zoom and their Facebook Live at Arabian Horse Times Facebook page. Please contact the ladies at Arabian Horse Times if you have any marketing or print media or digital media needs, or you want to broaden your footprint or modernize your website, your stallion cards, your farm videos. They're doing a fantastic job being technology first of all the Arabian Horse community media partners. Contact Arabian Horse Times, based in George, Minnesota. Thank you, Laura Ames and team of the Arabian Horse Times for tonight's Kiesner Stallion Shave Off.
Looks like a woodchuck did it on this side.
Sorry. Better with horses. This is a lot harder. Everybody makes it so easy.
I think I do have more hair than a lot of those guys.
Yeah.
As they finish up Chance here and his older brother Ty, another great horseman as well, back home in California with his folks, going through this hard time. We don't forget Jeff Lee and Mel Lee going through some tough times, as well as our good friend Richard Petty. Many of these horsemen we've stabled with, shown with, been judged by, they're our friends. And the Arabian Horse Stress Fund is going to step up this evening and help them through these difficult times. Because we know medical bills can get a little crazy, even if you have good health insurance. You have deductibles, you got visits, you have payments at your farm that might get delayed. So that's where the Arabian Horse Stress Fund steps up and helps in these difficult situations with your family.
Yeah. Well, yeah, the head underneath it is not that great, is it? There's a lot of stories going to that. Dips and divots.
Yeah. All right, I might have to do this.
Apparently, a horse show is not the safest place to grow up in. I don't know.
All right.
Almost. I'll have to do a little touch up.
All right, he looks like The Rock.
Yeah.
There you have it. Number one.
Very nice, Chance.
Oh, very man. Nice.
If you can't go to the barber, go to Joel's Kitchen.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so we're going to get started here, huh?
So Joel, let's read off the six stallions that we're going to invite bids on this evening, but we also take straight donations to the Arabian Horsemen's Trust Fund. Anything's a donation tonight. We will not neglect you. So if you're not breeding this year, you can still donate money this evening and help. And if you're breeding, there's six great opportunities, the stallions of extreme English Pezzer type that you're offering this evening, buddy.
Absolutely. We're going to auction off a Fire's Air, KW Micah, Saxton DGL, Coltrane SS, Divine Style, and Inception. And I think we're gonna do a Fire's Air first.
Is that what Let's go with the going? King of Kings, Joel. He's got over 600 foals on the ground. He's 18 years of age. His children all swept the English division last year at the US Nationals. This is an important stallion in our breed. And here's an opportunity tonight to help out the Arabian Horsemen's Distress Fund and raise money, and you receive a breeding to this beautiful stallion if you're the highest bidder, Joel. His retail stud fee is $4,000 to give you an idea what his market value is if you call the office tomorrow and talk to Ashton. So I give you a point of reference. This is a Fire's Air, first stallion in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off, powered by the Arabian Horse Times this evening, raising money on behalf of the Arabian Horsemen's Distress Fund. All bids and money donated tonight is a 501(c) tax deductible donation. We appreciate it.
Right. There's a picture of a Fire's Air right there. How lucky are we that he's been in our lives? It's a little unusual how we're going to do this. We're doing it through text. You can do it by texting onto the Facebook Live. Some people are going to bid by proxy, either with Deb Trebesh, Arabian Horse Times. Some people are bidding through Ashton or myself. They have, some people have called ahead. We're gonna figure this out a little bit as we go. I don't know kind of where we are yet.
Joel, why don't we start out at $1,000 with the fire's there? Nice round number.
Seems like a good buy to me, Rory.
So he's retail study 4,000. He's nominated all the important programs around the world for your babies. AEPA, Scotts Signature. He's Breeder Sweepstakes. He's a national champion. He's produced national champions. He's by the great Fire Baby. He's had the Brass Dutter Brass Miss, Royal Pedigree. He's proven it in the show ring. He's proven it in the Stallion Barn. He's raising money tonight. We started $1,000, ladies and gentlemen. Raven Horseman Stress Fund donation. The highest bid gets the breeding to a fire's heir. You're responsible for the collection and any vet bills associated breeding your mare. Free breeding right, life full guarantee, Joel.
Oh yeah, yeah. Use the breeding this year or next year, and you know, his semen is it's bionic. So even if your mare isn't that fertile, you don't have to worry about it. He'll go in there and he'll just make a baby, no problem.
That's right. He's had over 600 registered babies. This is a serious horse. We want to thank his owners, Bill and Shirley Rylick, for donating this breeding this evening and stepping up to help the Raven Horse Distress Fund. 100% of the proceeds, correct, Joel and Ashton? 100% right. Of what we raise on the fire's air goes to the Horse Distress Fund.
That's right. 100% of it. 100% of it is going to go to the Cancer Warriors Fund.
Excellent.
So, and it's all, of course, you know, tax deductible. So that's, you know, it's a great deal. So I don't know.
My wife says she sees $1,000 coming through. You're going to comment on Facebook or text or email or call somebody associated with our team this evening and put your bid, your donation in. You can even just say donation if you want. Any numeral amount we'll collect.
Cedar Ridge up to 2,000.
Very nice. $2,000 on a fire's air, horse distress fund. After we sell this breeding, Joel, we take the first lap through your lettuce.
That's right. I just got a bid up to $2,500.
Very nice. On a fire's air, the first of six stallions tonight, and the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off. We're allowing about 5 minutes of stallions. So if you're interested in bidding, or you have a friend that's bidding, or you heard they want to bid, let's get going. We're going to allow just a few minutes, so we're not here all night. Six stallions to go through. They're all excellent. We have a fun time talking about each stallion, but we're also going to enjoy watching Joel get six laps through his lettuce tonight.
Yeah. All right.
So Joel's at 2,500.
We're looking for 3,000. That's our next bid. His retail stuff, he's $4,000. We called Ash in the office tomorrow.
Stuart Vesting went to 26. Oh. 26. Oh, so we got 3,000 on from at the Arabian Horse Times through Deb.
Very nice.
That must be
$3,000 for a fire's heir, 18-year-old national champion stallion, leading sire in the division.
We're up to 3,500. Yes. Boy, now we're cooking with butter here, folks. Sorry.
100% goes to Arabian Horse Distress Fund tonight. This is a great cause, tax deductible donation. You win a breeding and you can straight donate at any point tonight. Just say donate $100, $500. We'll take it all.
Rory, I have 4,000 for a fire's heir from Sarah Skata.
Very nice, Sarah. Highland Pride girls.
Yep.
Her family was a California here and her cousin live here in Scottsdale. They ride with the Berkman Center.
Way to go, guys.
Yeah. Highland Pride stepping up at $4,000 for the high bid right now for a fire's heir, helping out the Raven Horse Distress Fund, Cancer Warriors.
Yeah, thank you. That's wonderful. Going to a great cause. Obviously, a fire's heir is the leading sire, has had the six consecutive open English pleasure champions at US Nationals, 6 years in a row. This horse has never been less than first place. He's been unanimous every time he's been out.
Just really hard to do.
4,500, Joel, from Rob Hare.
Yeah. Oh, Rob Hare.
Right,
you know that, gentlemen? That's a nice bid. He might have been breeding. Hope he has a beautiful mare to breed to fire's heir. Be a future show champion, as well as nice pedigree add to his breeding program. Yeah.
Signature Oak. Oh, sorry. Signature Oaks has put together a very fine group of mares up in Michigan, and they are breeding some very nice horses.
Yeah.
They haven't been at it as long as some of the other people yet, but I'm telling you what, they're putting together a fine group of horses and doing a first-class job.
Quality's better than quantity, Joel and Ashton, and we're at $4,500 on Fire's Air. We're above this par value. This is a charitable donation. Winning bid.
That's awesome. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
So I have Sarah at $4,500, and then I have Rob Parr at $4,500.
So would you, one of you, like to step up for charity for another $100 and break the tie? That would be great. As we wind this down,
right?
The first of six stallions offered tonight.
I guess who, I don't know who was first.
I don't know who was first either.
That was 1 minute ago.
You got a coin? You gonna flip a coin there, Joel? Maybe fire up those clippers?
Rob Hart just went to 4,800.
Oh, he's serious.
Yeah.
He wants it. Thanks, Rob.
Thanks, Rob. And so I feel like, I mean, in order to keep things moving along, I feel like, we don't want to drag it out too long, but, we should start next horse. We're going to put a timer on it.
Okay.
I think on this one, we're getting our feet wet. We're going to say 5 minutes on the next one. That seems like.
So I think Rob bought it at 4,800. Right?
Is
4,800 is what I hear is the high bid with Rob up in Michigan. The name of the farm again, Joel?
Ready to roll. All in, all done?
All in, all done on my side.
4,800, Rob Har. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you to all the other bidders that got us to this point. Rob, great job. We're going to take one lap through Joel's mop here. 1/6 of his famous hairdo is going to be on the floor here in moments. Who's doing the shaving, Joel?
Rory, I spent my whole life, really, I've had an advantage. Probably an unfair advantage with my good looks. I always get to the front of the line, you know.
It isn't because of the cute girls next to you, huh?
Well, so, you know, I mean, this is probably going to even things up a little bit. So here we go.
Okay. So this is for Fire's Air.
Fire's Air, the first breeding sold tonight of 6 for the Kiesner Shave Off. The first of 6 cuts through the mop top of the fifth beetle here, Joel Kiesner. Ooh. What's our blade of preference there, Ashton?
I got some 40s.
Boy, oh boy, Rob Bick went with a 50. Carolyn didn't mess around.
I know.
I think that's a lot.
Is that good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, guys, you ready to move on to our second of 6 stallions for the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off?
Oh, hey, that's not too bad. Kind of looks like Ty Wallace.
You look like you should be riding a skateboard 1984 in San Fernando Valley there. That's good.
Well,
Joel, let's move on to KW Micah. He stands at your farm. He's a $3,000 retail stud. He's a son of national champion Mamaj, who's by Zodiac Matador. Mamaj had the great heir, son daughter, Fire Magic. We used to have her at Dolorosa Arabians. KW Micah is out of a Bosca Fire daughter that's out of a Brass daughter. It goes back to a Boss Flame daughter. Lots of trot, lots of structure, like athletic building, that pedigree. This is a great horse. Reserve national champion last year, I believe, in the AEPA Futurity, correct? At U.S. Nationals?
Yep. And then went out to Scottsdale, and I'd say he improved by about 40% from October, and he went and had a big time in Scottsdale and put on a real horse show and had a lot of fun. And
getting stronger as he turns into his 5-year-old year. Is this the first year you're breeding him, or does he have some foals on the ground?
You know, we bred him one time last year. He's got one baby coming,
That Mike Wheelahan owns.
That Mike Wheelahan owns.
That's a smart breeder. That's a smart breeder.
Well, yeah.
Out of an Affairs Air daughter.
Yeah.
Exciting.
We honestly we didn't break him until until he was four. So he just kind of came into the whole thing really late last year. We sort of skidded sideways into U.S. Nationals, but we made it. And but it was about midway last year.
I've got 2,500 for Micah from Carmel River.
All right.
Excuse me.
And the more you talk, Joel, the more the bids are going. You're doing the right thing, buddy.
Okay. Anyway, we started noticing how good he was getting about midway through the year, and made a couple phone calls and said, "Hey, you gotta try him out." And this year, well, he's getting some attention, and we'll have a very good idea. But he's a great individual, and we just usually find that horses breed how they look, and he's got a pedigree to back it up. So
Kingswood Farms is the owner, Christy, Ken, Kathy Kaneship.
Yep.
Thank you.
The Ship family should be proud. He bred $3,000 right now on KW Micah, this young stallion, reserve national champion last year in AEPA at U.S. Nationals, Scottsdale champion this year, 2020, the last big horse show for most of us. He's already at par value, $3,000 at the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off for the Raven Horse Mr. Stress Fund this evening. Stallion number two of the six we're offering.
Sorry, I should put my glasses on. That's awesome. Yay.
So you're at, what are you at, Rory?
We're at $3,000 with Andy Boylan.
Now we're at 31.
Andy Boylan.
Andy Boylan.
3,500.
Step it up.
3,500.
Ty Wallace, $3,500. Spent a little bit of his profits from all those calls there with the Blackbirds.
Well, he's giving back. So there you go.
Reinvesting.
That's right.
Yes. Thank you, Ty.
Thank you, Ty.
Do you think he knows how to inseminate a mare, or he only knows how to work on the other end?
I think Ty's pretty good.
He'll figure it out.
Yeah.
There's YouTube videos for everything now, Joel.
He's got people.
Yeah.
He probably has several people to handle that.
Several black trucks. Yeah. So we're talking about KW Micah right now, 5-year-old son. Son of Mamaj, national champion open English with Shan Wilson, started by Rob Bick, son of Zodiac Matter, out of the Airstone daughter, went through those laws with sales, CF Fire Magic. He's out of a Boston Fire daughter, that's out of a Brass daughter, that's out of a Boss Flame daughter. That's old school trot, strong hind end, good minded, bright eye.
I got to tell you, he trains like an old school horse. He really does, which is, it's a lot of fun to do because it's kind of a little blast from the past. He trains like a horse of the 80s, which is
it's okay.
Computer went out.
Hey Ty, I know you can hear me. That's why I'm giving you a hard time. I like seeing those vets reinvest. That's good to see this. Someday I might be good enough to have you visit my horses. I get your third or fourth ranks that come to my farm.
Okay, so are we at 3,500 with Ty?
Yes. What kind of mare are you using, Ty? What are you thinking? Type in the comment box the breeding on your mare. We're curious what you're going to make with this beautiful if you win.
Are we selling that?
Somebody was in at 35 with me, and I don't know if they're in or out. Let me, what's our time? How much time do we have?
Just a minute or so left on KW Micah.
Let me just, let me see if they want to stay in.
Are you at a tie? Is that what you are? You're at a tie with Ty and somebody else?
Somebody else.
No, Ty.
Have you ever seen an auction go like this before?
It's better than some of the live ones.
Well, anyway, he's a fantastic horse. He's breeding a lot of great mares this year, and so excited to see his babies hit the ground. The one that Mike Wheelahan has this year, and then a bunch coming in 2021. Super excited.
Kentley Dean says she wants to go 3,600 on KW Micah from North Carolina. That's another vet. I love these Brits want to infuse and breed Arabian horses, support our community.
It hit the stall for 30 seconds, didn't it?
Thank you.
A debt for $100 for every 30 seconds. Oh. I got 4,000. Like eBay. I got 4,000 now.
Whoa.
So there.
4,000.
Take that.
Is that from your daughter? Is that a secret bid?
No. No, she doesn't have that kind of money. I wouldn't let her spend that.
Her allowance is not substantial, is what you're saying.
No, it's not.
So we're at $4,000, Joel and Ashton, on KW Micah. Pretty exciting. His retail stud fee is $3,000. We're supporting the Raven Horses Distress Fund tonight. You can just straight donate, Joel and Ashton. If anybody out there, just put it in your comment box. We'll, Mary Trowbridge and her team, the Raven Horse Times, will collect the monies later on. But you can do a straight donation just to support the fund, our cancer warriors.
You can just do that right on your texting on the Facebook, just like how people are bidding. Just donate just like that, and we'll keep track of it, and we'll give you a phone call. Big Jim will give you a phone call to collect.
Deb Trash at the Times always collects. She's great. So Joel, we think we're winding down here on KW Micah. We're at $4,000 at this point.
So that's Diane and Nat Franklin from Seattle. Thank you guys so much. Thanks, Greg, for the help. And honestly, that is so great. And they are, you could buy the breeding cheaper than that. So we appreciate it. Thanks for the help. I'm just going to tell you a quick story. So we have somebody new in our office who, I'll tell this while you shave.
If you can hear. I don't know if you can hear.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Somebody new working in our office. And over the last couple of days, it's been a whirlwind of activities, all the emails and phone calls and stuff, trying to organize all this. And she says, my goodness. She says, your breed really, really, all you people really support each other, don't you? I said, well, I think so, yeah. She says, I've never seen anything like it. I clearly was in the wrong breed.
Aww, that's
so nice. So that's really nice. I thought I'd pass that along to all of you out there.
Thanks, Jen.
Yeah.
So,
I think we like to reference, this isn't the Arabian horse business, this is the Arabian horse community. And there's families in the community and here all to help each other, support each other. Here we go, lap two. Where will Ashton go next? Six laps through Joel's Chrome Dome. He will look like Mr. Clean by the end of the night. Joel, you might need a sponsor for sunscreen as well.
I can't hear. It's kind of loud over here on this side.
He said you look great.
Oh, thanks. I'm sure I do.
How's that?
Wonderful.
Is that good?
Yeah.
I think we should just leave it like that.
All right.
It's very easy to see.
Who's next?
We're on our way. We're going to start with number three, Saxton DGL, owned by Dave and Gail Linegar, Maroon Fire Ravens, and Tim and Marty Shea. That's a powerful team. They've bred some important horses in your life, haven't they, Joel?
You're close on, you're right on most of that, Rory, except Saxton is owned by the Lenmark family.
Oh, I apologize.
That's okay. Bred by Maroon Fire, and all the rest of it was correct. Yep.
The Lenmark Sharon Natalie and Russ. We thank them for their donation this evening to Saxton DGL. Joel, national champion of the Maturity English, the Junior English, the Open English, the Open Driving, Junior Derived English, and Junior Derived Driving. This is kind of a Swiss Army knife of the Arabian horse industry as a stallion. Bred by Maroon Fire, who is just a legendary breeding program, Hall of Fame breeder.
Yep, all that's very, very true. He's got the heart of a lion.
Sired by a Fire's Heir, our first stallion that we saw this evening, the undefeated unanimous national champion. Fire's Heir is his sire. His mother's in a Fire baby daughter, Sweet Summer Fire, who's out of Primrosa, the Boss Classic daughter that goes back to a Negatrez mare. Definitely Linegar Maroon Fire breeding, managed by Tim and Marty Shea. This is a great horse. 9 years old, as you said, lion-hearted, Kingslayer, the Lindmark family. Thank you for donating and breeding this evening in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off. We are on lot three, Saxton DGL. Retail stud fee, $3,000. What will we land with that breeding tonight for Horsemen's Distress Fund Cancer Warriors?
Looks like Rob and Carolyn have donated $500, and Bradley, Marlowe, and Joe have also donated $500 so far.
Awesome. That's very nice. Those are straight donations, you guys, to the Horses and Stress Fund with no obligation to bid or be competitive. We appreciate that. We need every little dollar. Right now, things are tough in the breed. People aren't going to shows. People are staying home watching us. It's tough.
Yeah, it is. It is. There's no question about it. And what we've been saying is how just everybody's coming together to support one another and to support everybody in need, especially when our friends and family are sick. And it's just, it's really beautiful. It's really awesome that everybody is donating. And even if you don't have a mayor, you know, just donating like Joe and Brad did and Rob and Carolyn, that's amazing. Thank you.
It is amazing.
We have another 100 from Laura Mickelson.
Thank you, Laura.
What was that bid, Joel? Where are we starting out at? $1,000, and where are we now?
Let's see.
2,000.
2,000. Very nice. This is Saxton DGL, son of a fire's heir, and the fire baby daughter, Sweet Summer Fire, owned by the Lindmark family, donating a breeding. Winner gets a breeding to this beautiful national champion in 5 different divisions. Now breeding some beautiful mares. If you don't have a mare, Joel Nashman, I'm sure you could locate one to match perfectly with the stallion for the bidder.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
No, might even be able to find an embryo out of one of your stars. Maybe they don't need to buy the mare. Maybe they can purchase an embryo and create their own legacy this direction.
We've got another $100 donation from Joey and Meg Gwynn, $500 from Sean and Carmel, $100 from Annie Boylan, $500 from Ty Wallace, $200 from Kim Cook, $500 from Virginia Godwin, $100 from Randy, $200 from and $50 from Kaylee Meyer.
Wow, that's great.
This is the Goodwill horse. He just ignited an overflow of straight donations. That's amazing.
And he is a Goodwill horse.
That is amazing. Yeah.
I've watched him show. He's fun to watch. He's expressive, beautiful, sharp horse. Lots of tail carriage and halter guys like that, but flashy horse. You guys, we're at $2,000 on Saxton DGL. Is that correct?
Yep. And we got 22.5 now. We got 22.5 on him now.
Okay. He's our third of 6 stallions in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off this evening. Joel's had 2 passes with the razors go through his hair there with Ashton, 40 blade. We're going to finish him off by the 6th stallion. We might even sell an eyebrow or two if people want to get a little crazy tonight.
We've got another $250 from Gail Lampy and $100 from Gino Leary.
That's like $2,000 just in straight donations alone in the last 20 minutes. Pretty impressive, Raven Horse community.
Super impressive. Thank you. This is awesome. This is great.
Ashton, collection days are what days at your farm for these stallions?
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
And can you do counter to counter? Is it all FedEx? How do we do this?
Yep. We've been doing some counter to counter, even with the Delta Airlines, you know, and the lack of the flights going out and stuff like that. We have been able to get semen shipped out via Delta. So that's been working. Of course, FedEx. I try to
Sex by FedEx.
Post stuff out there. So
I believe Ashton, we're at 2,500 on Saxon DGL.
Awesome.
He's 9 years old, again, sired by the great Fire's Heir, who's also lives with you guys. He's out of a Fire Baby daughter, that's out of a Boss Classic daughter, that's out of an Agatrash daughter. Very proven pedigree. Lots of famous horses in there that have all accomplished great things in our breed. 2,500 for stallion number 3 this evening in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off. It's Saxton DGL.
Yeah, he's a just a beautiful animal. So talented.
Yeah, got some nice babies on the ground that people are really enjoying training. I think that they're going to keep on doing great.
What programs is he nominated to, you guys? I'm assuming AEPA sweepstakes.
Yep. AEPA. Yep.
AEPA and sweepstakes.
Yep.
Important stuff. Payback programs for your marking your offspring, or go show that horse with you guys, or other great trainers in our breed. A lot of saddle seed horses he produces. What kind of mares would I take to him?
You know what? all of anything that isn't heavily saturated with the Fire Baby, because he has
the process. Yeah.
Yep. Which, well, you know, people are looking more and more for those things, so they're coming more to the surface. So
saddlebred mares. He has some beautiful half Arabs.
We have another $200 from Jessica Anderson, $1,000 from the Lindmark family, $1,000 from the Lawrence family, not counting Saxton's stud fee donation. We are up to $14,500 total so far.
Wow.
Amazing. Thank you, guys.
And that's halfway through, Joel. Joel, we're only numbers 3 stallion of 6. We're about wrapping up here on Saxton DGL. We're at $2,500, I believe, is the last bid. Do you have anything else current?
I got $2,500.
You got $2,500. Anybody else out there in Facebook land on the Raven Horse Times Facebook page? You can text Joel or Ashton or Laura Ames. You can text Ashley Gloon. You can text my wife, Sue O'Neill. I can't get to my phone, but shout it out. Put it in the comments.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. We ready?
All right. Here we go.
Should I do the front?
There he is. Sold at 2,500. Is that correct, guys?
Last.
500.
Boy, oh boy, we might have to have a second stud double. There's not enough hair left to do 6 passes. Thank you again to the Lindmark family for supporting this evening and allowing us to auction off a breeding of Saxton DGL for the Raven Horse Mr. Stress Fund. Kiesner Stallion Shave Off.
How's that?
Should be about halfway through.
Okay.
All right. Ashton and Joel, let's move on to Stallion 4 this evening. Retired as the national champion park horse 2 years ago to stud. I'd love to do that myself. Coltrane SS. Sired by the great national champion Noble Express, who you also showed the national champion park title. It was by MHR Nobility. Coltrane SS, out of the brass, out of brassness, shares the same dam as the great A Fire's Heir, national champion park horse, owned by the great Conway Arabians, Peter and Lori Conway up in Minnesota, one of the biggest supporters of the Raven horse industry through breeding horses, volunteering time, donating money. They're just great people. This is a Coltrane SS breeding. His retail stud fee, $2,500. He's nominated every program imaginable for mare owners. Here it is. We're going to offer him this evening Coltrane SS, a breeding in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off.
So Coltrane is doing a great job. We've had enough opportunity to see his babies now, and they're all hockey. Great hocks, great straight tails, flexible necks.
Chances broken, probably 3 of them at my farm. And so he can attest to their great mentalities. They are just super trainable, talented,
straight moving horses,
quality,
athletic, short backs.
He's really doing a great
job. Really
built to do the job. Basically built to do a job of show horse, saddle seat division. They're attractive, so they stand out in a very deep class. I know they're athlete gifted, but they're pretty horses. They're really pretty horses.
Yeah. You know, I wanted to tell I never shared this. But I have, I'm sorry.
3,000 bid, Joel, on Coltrane SS. $3,000 bid already on him.
Really?
Great.
I'm trying to tell a story here.
I'm sorry. I just get excited when I see money. It's a halter trainer in me.
Okay. So a long, long time ago, when I just started to work at Las Moravians, and, I was working a Wisdom Son, and Doc LaCroix came by, and he didn't talk to me very much. He only talked to you if you were really important, usually, and I was not. But he came by, and he thought this horse had particular good looks. So he stopped and he looked at it, and he stood back and he put his hand over it. And he looked at me and he says, that horse is a park horse. He has the body of a park horse. Look at this. And then he described it to me. And so I never forgot it. And Coltrane has that body, and Coltrane has a very, he has a old style frame, you know, his shoulder, his short back, his hip, the way he's built, you know, down, he's built so athletic. He's not, I mean, he is a brute of a horse, but he's built athletically to lower himself down. And that's, I mean, he's an athlete, but he has the same body style that horse had. And I don't know that I've shared that story before, but I was thinking about it the other day. It just popped through my head again, as things often just kind of drift by into my head, and then they drift.
But he has some wisdom, Joel, in his dam line. You know, Brass Miss is out of a nobility daughter. It's out of Miss Wisdom. That's a famous wisdom daughter. He's double nobility in his pedigree. He shares the same mother as a Fire's Heir and that nice halter that Rob Bick showed years ago, the full sister of Fire's Heir. A firestorm. Oh, yeah. There's a lot of attractive.
And obviously,
big motors. But yep. I remember interviewing you and this horse. He came out of the ring at Nationals 2 years ago, and he retired that night at the Park National Championship. And he's the kind horse for a stud. Yep. Just come out of the ring in a high energy park class, all the crowds. That horse is just nice to be around.
He's a nice guy. Yep. Great big soft eye, a very kind horse. He's got a heart this big.
$3,200 is what I'm hearing as latest bid. You have any?
$35 actually, and an additional $250 donation from the Lalo family, plus $300 from Gail Walden.
Very nice. Wow. So to revisit, anybody can donate tonight. Just comment or text. We'll collect on it later. We're selling 6 breedings. We're on stallion number 4, Coltrane SS, raising money for the Arabian Horse Sisters Trust Fund, specifically Cancer Warriors, Richard Petty, Jeff Lee, and Mike McDaniel, going through some tough times right now. We're shaving heads around the community. But Joel and Ashton Kiesner Training of Louisville, Tennessee, stepped up and their clients and organized a great fundraiser tonight. And we're on Stallion 4, but you can donate any amount tonight. Mary Trowbridge and her team at the Arabian Horse Distress Fund graciously accept any donation. They send you the nicest letter when they receive it. They process it seamlessly, professionally. It's a great organization. It's 501(c), completely tax deductible. And we're selling Coltrane at $3,500 right now.
We're at $3,500.
His stud fee is a very reasonable $2,500 for a national champion park horse. Peter and Lori want to see babies on the ground. They want to see people pulling the triggers and breeding horses and breeding to this horse. That's great support. And we're at $3,500 on this beautiful national champion park horse, sired by Noble Express.
Who has that bid? Do you know?
I don't have that. I heard it from Megan. Is that right, Megan? Did you have that bid?
Apparently, Barb Chur.
Oh,
Barb Coor, Strawberry Banks Farm, always there when we need a fundraiser help. Every year she donates one breeding to Bosque of Fire, Frozen Semen at the Horseman's Distress Fund, at the Horseman's Awards. Her and Brian Mercer team show at the shows and breed Graven Horse, but they always come and step up when we need to raise some real money. And we appreciate Barb Coor. Big pardon?
Are we ready?
I think we're ready. So we're going to close it at $3,500 with Barb Coor. One last go.
Last bid so far, just with a $300 donation from Donnie Bullock, and then a Region 3 challenge for Region 3 members of $100 to step up and match.
Fantastic. So let's sell this, Joel and Ashton. Coltrane SS, National Champion Park Horse, stand at stud with you guys in Tennessee. $3,500 we raised just in one breeding sold for the Horse Distress Fund, including straight donations added on.
Two more studies.
And Joel takes another pass of the clippers for the team here. And those eyebrows are available, aren't they? Straight donation, $1,000 an eyebrow tonight.
What do you say?
He said $1,000 an eyebrow, right? The donations.
Oh no, no, no. We got.
We can just do 1,000
for the eyebrows to go. Get to 30,000, the eyebrows will go.
Oh, wait.
And do we get a bronze?
Huh?
Can we get a bronze from you as well?
No.
That looks good right now.
Just the eyebrows.
You look like you could go in Full Metal Jacket or Platoon.
It's very aggressive.
So, Joel, let's move on to RLL Divine Style.
Yeah. So the only thing that I should be able to do like 100 push-ups, right, with this, but probably
yeah. Not. Be careful when you go to the bar next week. RLL Divine Style is the next stallion we're offering this evening. A son of a Fire Bay V, who's no longer with us, out of the MHR nobility daughter, IXL Miss Firefly, who's out of the very impressive El Ghazi daughter, RY Fire Ghazi. And remember her grandmother, RL Rawfire, the daughter of La Fire, national champion. Great pedigree, impressive show horse. We've seen him multiple times. He's reserve national champion in all the major English divisions. Graciously donated this evening, Duke's Breeding. That's his barn name, Divine Style, by Delson Arabians, Nancy Delsey, and Carol Sandusky. We're selling Stallion number 5, Joel and Ashton, RL Divine Style.
I've got a $300 donation from Cynthia Berkman. Rob has $500 for your right eyebrow, and Stu is matching that for your left.
Come on, guys.
No. No, it works. You get the $30,000, the eyebrows will go.
Rob and Suzanne are each donating $200. We're currently at an additional $100 per eyebrow. We'll get there. Currently at $2,100 for the bid.
How much for the horse?
$2,100 for the horse, $300 each eyebrow currently. Okay.
What if we just get one eyebrow?
So we're keeping you updated on those eyebrows. Huh? Yeah.
Delson Arabians, ladies, Nancy Delsey and Carol Sandusky, thank you for donating your breeding this evening for the Horse with Stress Fund, the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off. We're selling Stallion number 5, ROL Divine Style, multi-national champion stallion in the show ring, sired by Fire Bay V, at the nobility daughter, that's out of the El Ghazi daughter, that's out of the world famous RL Rawfire. Here he is.
Yes. Great horse.
So
tell me what he's like turned loose, Joel. Is this an impressive horse when you turn him loose in the paddock?
He's even more impressive under saddle. This horse,
he really comes to you.
I mean, he's beautiful turned loose in a paddock, but under saddle, he's a dream.
He got loose and ran down the road the other day. No, that was impressive.
Nancy, don't believe him, he didn't.
Sorry about that again, guys, I swear.
He is really, it's a great, great horse. He's beautiful. He's quintessential. His pedigree.
2,700.
He's got a Fire Bay V neck and tail. He's got the nobility rear end. Such a beautiful horse. Great big kind eye.
He's so kind. He's so smart. He's so correct.
Yep. So is his mother a full sister to Noble Express? Is that correct? If I read that right?
Yep.
Very impressive.
I've got $3,000 on Divine Style.
Okay.
$3,000 bid. This is the 5th of 6 stallions tonight, guys. That'd one more after this available.
Okay. Also have David on Facebook. Was it $2,500? So you're above David Boggs.
David Boggs, thanks for stepping up. Beautiful presentation you did the other day on Facebook through the Raven Horse Times at your farm in Scottsdale. Probably the finest packaged presentation I've ever seen.
We're at 5,000.
We're at 5?
We're at 5.
That's our leader for the night, Joel and Ashton. That is a high bid so far of the whole evening.
Who has the 5?
Let me check on that. It's a proxy bid.
Okay. Dels, you announced that. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if that was the 5,000 though.
The 5,000 is a bid, right?
5,000 is a bid.
Okay. There's also another.
So Delson Arabian. Delson Arabians, who owns Divine Style, wants to donate $5,000.
Hey.
Straight donation to the Horseman's Distress Fund this evening.
Straight donation, pretty. Amazing.
Give them a big hug next time.
Nancy, you're not trying to get
that's my... important. That's important.
Yeah, that's really nice. But Nancy, that's you're not bad. Trying to get my eyebrows shaved.
Currently David Boggs and Cedar Ridge at 5,000.
Wow. This is cool.
I think there needs to be a halter stallion shave off next week. Then we'll do the hunter group and then we'll do the western group. We'll just keep going throughout.
Just David Boggs up to 6,000.
Who?
Now he's at 6,000?
Yeah, it's the same bidder. They just added an extra 1,000.
Wow.
For the heck of it. That's awesome. It's amazing.
Joel, these $100 and $200 donations are important because that's what people probably would have been doing on Friday night, easily dropping that at dinner or dancing or bowling. So we appreciate that. Think about it. Instead of going out on the town, throw a little money towards the Horses of Stress Fund tonight. We're entertaining you just as much as you'd see at the local pub.
Well, maybe.
When we get to the eyebrows, it's going to be like 2 a.m. at the pub.
So where are we now?
I think we're at 6. Is it 5 plus 1,000? Is that how I see it?
Yeah.
So 6,000.
That's fantastic. Our own divine style.
We're about ready to close it, Joel.
So yeah, I mean,
okay.
6,000 for the breeding, and Del San Arabians is doing $5,000 donation. That's ridiculously
good. $11,000.
Wow. Yeah. Ladies, thank you.
Thank you. Gosh, I feel like we're getting close to eyebrows.
No, we're not.
Megan,
yeah.
where's our subtotal one stallion left to go this evening?
Currently, without this bid, we are at 27,350. So with this bid, we're at 33,350.
With one stallion left to go. Is that correct, guys? One stallion.
Correct.
We're at 33,000. What did you just bid 7,000 for? On what?
So we have. Really? Correction, this bid was bid up to 7,000 by Cedar Ridge and Midwest.
Cedar Ridge and Midwest. Good Minnesota breeders. 51 years Cedar Ridge has been around. I think David's been around 49 years showing horses for the Ames family.
Who's that guy?
No.
All right.
Joel, when you sat down today, Joel, what was that number in your head that you were thinking, some crazy number you thought we'd hit if everything worked out?
Yeah, I will personally add $500 for an eyebrow.
What's that?
What happened? They stuck that in when the clippers were on.
So, Joel, when you sat down this evening, what was the number you thought Fantasy Island you'd get near?
I was thinking 30,000.
So we're past that with one stallion to go.
Yep.
Wow.
Pretty good night.
I didn't think we'd get there, though.
I think people wanted to see you go bald.
Well, I think that's what's happening.
All right, so let's
get
to the
last
horse.
Eyebrows, really.
Yeah, going to the last horse, we are at $34,350.
Amazing.
Wow.
It's amazing.
Wow.
You guys are amazing.
Joel, let's introduce the sixth and final stallion, Inception, sired by Noble Express, out of the Fire Baby Eater, Bonita Fire, that's out of the Barbary Daughter. Well, Cora goes back to Edder, owned by Dave and Gail Inniger and Tim and Marty Shea, bred by them as well. This is Inception. His stud fee is $3,000. He's nominated all the major programs. Son of Noble Express. Inception is a national champion. He has over 100 babies on the ground. The oldest are just 2 years of age. This is an up-and-coming breeding stallion. Unanimous national champion 3 times in the AEPA, Junior Horse, and Park. Very important show horse currently. And just getting a start in the breeding shed with oldest babies 2 years old. Inception, stallion number 6, offered in the Kiesner Stallion Shave Off this evening.
Yeah, really, really good horse. Hey, Rory, I noticed I've got my computer screen up a little closer right now. Your hair looks really nice tonight.
It's a wig. It's a wig.
We're at $1,000 so far for Inception with Randy.
That's awesome.
Okay, we have a proxy bid at $1,500.
Great horse. Babies are really doing good.
Beautiful.
It's got really fine bone. He's also, when they hit the lottery and they get the best of their pedigrees.
We're at 2,000.
Inception got the best of his pedigrees. You know, he's got the fine bone, the beauty, and he's got the motion and the hawk from, you know, the right sides of his pedigrees, and the beautiful plumy tail, and the style of the Fire Bay side of it, and just it just all worked out. And he seems to be passing it along.
His dam line looks like with the started out the Maroon Fire and Tim and Marty Shade connection with the Barbary daughters, Brenda Etter, then brought in a Fire Baby and produced this line that we got really, you know, comfortable with them dominant showing in the 90s. And then they added Noble Express as another layer. He goes national champion with you in Park. And then they started breeding the Noble Express daughters on top of the Fire Baby daughters. And he is looks like the accumulation of a 25-year breeding program, essentially.
Yeah. You know, Rory, you already have four?
You have 4,000.
4,000 bid for Inception, our sixth stallion tonight and final stallion. We're still taking straight donations to anybody, the Horseman's Trust Fund, completely tax deductible write-off, 501(c). Mary Trowbridge and her team will handle all the payments. They're gracious.
We have a $300 donation from a DMV. We have $800, Rory from Mohawk, from Stu Bestie, with an additional $500 from Betsy. Plus an additional $200. So you're getting up there for your Mohawk, Rory.
Oh,
I haven't had one of those since there was more Beatles alive than are now. It's been a while. High school, maybe.
So Rory, I just wanted to tell you and everybody out there about this beautiful book that Dave and Gail Liniger of Maroon Fire Radiance put together of the legacy of A Fire Baby, Noble Express, Inception, and the horses that they bred, along with Tim and Marty Shay. It's a beautiful book that I can send out to anyone who wants one. They have sent out books to people that have bred to these stallions and people who have bought horses from Maroon Fire, but I have 400 in my office. That I will send out to anyone who wants one tomorrow. It's a beautiful book that they put together with pictures and just all kinds of information. It's
30 years of Maroon Fire breeding.
Yeah.
A lot of history there. A lot of effort they've put into supporting the breed and true breeders, generation after generation, not just breeding one time and selling horses, but they layer their breeding program, bring in stallions to add a new layer to the program. It's a very, very successful breeding program. And Tim and Marty Shay, we have to give them a nice shout out.
Oh,
great job managing those people. You're doing a great job over the years.
Oh, yeah.
We have Josh Shino at $4,250 for the bid. Rory, we have your Mohawk at $1,500. And Chase would like to know if the eyebrows are still up for bid because he, and I quote, would love to own those.
I'll cut my eyebrows as soon as we start injecting Lysol into ourselves.
Well, you know, the eyebrows are not for sale. If we get to $30,000,
which we have,
okay, then they're gone. I mean, for sale. I mean, you gotta put them in a little baggie and send them somewhere.
Hold out.
Will you paint in new eyebrows?
Okay, we're gonna hold out for more. Apparently, I don't know what they're worth, but so let's sell this horse. So I want to tell you two things. First of all. And then we're going to sell this horse because this is the last opportunity. And we got 2 minutes to do this.
Is that 4250 with Josh Shino, my next door neighbor?
Correct.
Okay. Good job, Josh.
So, you know, during this quarantine, everybody's been doing something. You know, you hear about, you know, people are feeding the healthcare workers that, you know, I hear about all these special things. At the end of this, when somebody asks you what you did, have an answer. Say, I helped raise $50,000 for my friends with cancer. We helped. I'm part of a group of people. We raised in one night money for my friends. That'll help people that are having trouble right now and years from now. Going to help people. That's what I did. We were a part of a group of people that did this. That's one thing I want to say. Forgot what the other thing was.
Joel, Ashton, your clients, the stallions, very impressive compilation of energies and efforts and donations tonight. You guys are really amazing to step up, support people in the Raving Horse community, and this was impressive. I never imagined $50,000, but we're right about there. We're selling the sixth stallion tonight. We're at 4,500, I believe. Megan?
We're at 4,500. We are going to fall short without the eyebrows, though, Joel.
What do you mean without the eyebrows?
You got to take those eyebrows off. We've got a lot of pledges right now.
So you have a separate fund for the eyebrows?
It appears so in the comments.
How much
is that? I got a Mohawk fund, Joel. You're going to have an eyebrow fund.
We're currently a little over 2,000.
One person is going to add $1,000 per eyebrow.
One more. What? Jamie's going to add $1,000 per eyebrow? And so if we don't accept the eyebrow money, it doesn't get put in?
We'll accept the eyebrow money. Come on.
And I just think it's a good idea.
Okay. Let's get to $5,000 on that stallion. I'll accept the eyebrow money.
And Austin Garrett is the winning bidder on the Jeopardy match. He is donating that all back.
Good job, Austin.
Awesome.
We'll be sending that Amazon Prime to us.
Jamie Costanzo is adding $1,000 per eyebrow.
Right. Okay. Wow. Okay. So, so where are we at with Inception?
4,500.
Okay. Have we been there for a little while?
Cindy Clinton would like to know if your chest hair is worth anything.
No, not. No.
It's above the collar, right, Joel? Everything's a sale above the collar tonight.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Get rid of fast.
I've got 4,700 on Inception from a person who's a non-bidder, a non-breeder.
She doesn't breed.
Leslie Goriev.
What is she doing?
4,700. That's pretty amazing.
We can find her a mare.
Yeah.
No problem.
We'll find her a mare.
Can we get to 5,000 and close it up this evening in the next minute or so, Joel? Can we get to 5,000 on Inception?
All right, one more bit on that horse. Let's get Leslie out of that because she does. I mean, I don't know what she's doing that, but let's get one more bit on that and let's get her out of that. And
$4,750 to Kelly Gilbert.
Oh, Kelly!
Kelly Gilbert, $4,750.
Okay, so
new money late.
Huh?
Some late money. That's good. She's been going all the way. Kelly's driving him all the way.
$4,750, Kelly Gilbert.
Yeah, let's call that good enough. And we'll accept the eyebrow money. And as a grand finale, shave my eyebrows.
Still that hair up there.
Yeah, we're going to do it all.
Are we ready?
As they say, the full money.
So Inception sells for $4,750. His published step is $3,000. Joel gets the last lap here and a little eyebrow itch.
Yeah, I don't know that I'm getting the last laugh.
Yeah.
You're kind of famous for your eyebrows.
You all are getting the last laugh, but we're happy to do it, right?
Yeah. Well, let's thank Arabian Horse Times.
Oh, you know what? They just upped themselves to 5,000.
Wow. Okay. They're gone.
Who just went to 5,000?
Kelly. It's Kelly. She outbid herself.
That's a great donation. Donating to Cancer Warriors, Jeff Lee, Mike McDaniel, Richard Petty this evening, raising nearly $50,000 for the Raven Horse Distress Fund. Keysner so Training, awesome. Joel Nashton, you got to be very proud of your team there, the Stallion owners.
I'm proud of
the Stallions.
Everyone out there.
We love you guys so much. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
I'm gonna read off the Stallions one more time, Joel, just to give them some acknowledgement. Fire's Air, Bill and Shirley Eilich. Inception, Dave, Scale Linegar, Tim and Marty Shea, Coltrane SS, the Conway Arabians, Divine Style, Delson Arabians, Nancy and Carol, Saxton DGL, and KW Micah. Those were the six stallions plus straight donations. You guys did an amazing job. This was fun. We stayed social distancing the whole night, and we raised $50,000. Can you say that? $50,000 this evening for the Raven Horseman's Distress Fund.
Unbelievable.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Thank you guys so much. I mean, I think. Yes. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much.
Wear a hat, son.
Get it over with.
And there she goes.
There she goes.
Private Keysner is in boot camp.
Wish good health to the three people.
We hope a speedy and full recovery for Jeff Lee, Mike McDaniel, and Richard Petty. Our prayers and thoughts are with you this evening. We hope this little bit helps you bridge some gaps to the Horses Press Fund.
No.
Oh, are we doing the eyebrows?
No, this is perfect.
This is like an extra $6,000.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, that's why we're doing it.
Away she goes. Holy smokes. Paint on some different ones. Horses and Trust Fund still takes donations anytime, every month, every week, every time there's a natural disaster. They've stepped up around the United States for the Raven Horse community. Think of them. Instead of going out to dinner or doing takeout, send them $100. And there she goes. Brow number one. Eyebrow number two.
Wow.
That guy deserves a gold medal. Horseman of the year right there, leading contender for shaving his eyebrows for charity.
Oh my God.
That's impressive. That's impressive. You know, I was only kidding about the eyebrows too.
Okay. There it is, folks.
Oh my God.
Wow. Okay. It's time to turn that camera off.
Good job, buddy. We'll see you soon. Bye. Take care.
Bye, guys. Thank you to all who donated.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you, the Raven Horse Times, for supplying us with all the technology and the processing tonight. They did a great job, Megan, Laura Ames, and Ashley, and Sarah, and Deb.
Oh, yeah. Thank you guys so much. Are we off?
Nope.
Thank you guys so much. The Times did such an amazing job putting everything together. Never could have done it.
Good night, you guys. Be safe. Great job. $50,000 for the Raven Horses Dress Fund this evening. Kiesner Stallion Shave Off is in the books.